Shalom, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, and welcome to Biblical Hebrew Foundation. What is the biblical definition of believing? Can one say they believe the word, not follow the word? One of the most often cited Bible verses is John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. But what is believing? What does it mean? Let's move on to a couple verses later in the same topic. John chapter 3 verses 20 and 21. For everyone practicing evil hates the light and does not come to the light, lest his deeds should be exposed. But he who does the truth comes to the light, that his deeds may be clearly seen, that they have been done in God. Those who hate the light do not come to the light. But those that love the light do the truth, because they came to the light that they love. Without defining the Word of God in context, we are at risk at defining an empty faith. Many people know in the back of their minds that they're missing something more in their faith. They know the truth, but do they know the whole truth? It is a frustrating feeling to be hungry for the truth and not know how to find it. As Hosea said in Hosea chapter 4 verse 6, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. God's word is the knowledge that we need. It's important, in order to gain that knowledge through the Holy Spirit, to biblically define the terms of the Bible in context. It's not about a theology book or what man defines as truth. It's what the Bible defines as truth. The Bible defines itself. It's important for us to realize this. Let's read John chapter 3 verses 20 and 21 again, which defines what believing looks like. For everyone practicing evil hates the light and does not come to the light, lest his deeds should be exposed. But he who does the truth comes to the light, that his deeds may be clearly seen that they have been done in God. We have two terms that must be defined by the Bible: truth and light. What is truth? Tehillim, Psalms 119, verse 142. And your law, in Hebrew, Torah, is truth. That is pretty simple. The law, the Torah, equals truth. What is the light? Proverbs chapter 6 verse 23. For the commandment is a lamp, and the law, Torah, a light. Reproofs of instructions are the way of life. The word law is the word Torah, and it just means God's instruction. It doesn't mean religion, and it doesn't mean that we follow the rabbis who don't believe in Yeshua. We follow only Jesus, only Yeshua, who is the Word. When we read in our Bibles the word law, Torah, we should understand that it only means God's instruction, God's word. Very important to emphasize that we do not follow the rabbis, we do not follow Judaism, and we do not follow books outside of the Bible. We follow only the written word of God in context. So the word Torah, according to the Bible, just means God's instruction, the whole Word of God, from Genesis to Revelation. It is hard to misunderstand that definition. The law, the Word of God, equals light, and it is our way of life. How the Bible defines terms is very, very important. It is through those definitions that we extract understanding. So let's review this one more time. What is truth? Psalms 119, verse 142. And your law, your word, is truth. What is light? Proverbs chapter 6, verse 23. For the commandment is a lamp, and the law a light. Reproofs of instruction are the way of life. Once again, the word there for law just means the word of God. So it can also be read like this: for the commandment is a lamp, and the word a light. Reproofs of instruction are the way of life. So according to the Bible, the law, the word, is the truth, the way, the truth, the life, and the light. That sounds exactly like Jesus, Yeshua. Yes, that's 100% right, because Yeshua is the Word. He is the Word in the flesh. John chapter 1, verse 14. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld His glory, the glory as of the Holy Begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. And in Hebrew it says, and the Word became flesh and tabernacled among us. In Hidgalut, Revelation chapter 19, 13, we see the Lord Yeshua returning as the Word, because the Word is forever. He is dressed in a robe dipped in blood, and His name is the Word of God. Is not the law of God also the Word of God? Isaiah said in chapter 2, verse 3, for out of Zion shall go forth the law, the Word, and the Word of the Lord from Yerushalayim, from Jerusalem. Yeshua is the way, the truth, and the life, and light, because He is the Word. John chapter 14, verse 6, Jesus, Yeshua, answered, I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through Me. And we know that Yeshua and the Father are one. John chapter 10, verse 30, I and the Father are one. The Messiah, Yeshua, is the way, truth, life, and light, because He is the Word. He taught the Word. He practiced the Word. He corrected from the Word. He instructed us to follow and walk in the same exact example of the Word, because we are His disciples. Yeshua, Jesus, said it with His own mouth. John chapter 13, verse 15, I have set you an example that you should do as I have done for you. Something to ponder on. He did not teach and do everything during His ministry in order to cancel or in order to say, never mind. Do a different Word of God now. He did not teach that we are to ignore the Word of God and that He came to make a new Word of God. We find that the Word of God, the way, the truth, the life, the light, He showed up in the flesh and walked among us, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. He is the Word. And we know that Yeshua, Jesus, God, died on the cross on the tree for our sins, rose on the third day, and by His blood, if we repent and believe, we have full redemption of sins and eternal life. So if we cancel the Word of God, we've canceled Jesus, because Yeshua is the Word. Many people are confused. They think, the Word of God, I thought I had freedom in Christ, in Jesus, in the faith. Yes, you do. We all do. But freedom from what? Freedom from obeying His Word? God forbid. Elohim 3:31, Romans 3:31. Do we then make void the law, the Word, through faith? Certainly not. On the contrary, we establish the law, the Word. And once again, the word there for law is the word Torah in Hebrew, and Torah only means God's instruction. It does not mean that we follow Rabbinic Judaism. We follow only Jesus in context. It is because of Yeshua, Jesus, that we uphold and establish His Word in our lives. Yeshua came to free us from the curse of our sin and to teach us how to not sin. Sin is defined in breaking God's law, God's Word. 1 John chapter 3, verse 4, everyone who makes a practice of sinning also practices lawlessness. Sin is lawlessness. Sin is bondage. God's law, God's Word, is not bondage. How could obedience to God's law, God's Word, be bondage, and then sin also be bondage? God's law, God's Word, defines sin. Yeshua is freedom because Yeshua is the law. He is the Word. And the Word of God, the law of God, is freedom. Psalms 119, verse 44 and 45. So shall I keep your law, your Word, continually, forever and ever. And I will walk in liberty, for I seek your precepts. The Word of God, the law, is the Word, and it is the way. It is the truth. It is the light. it is the life. And also, as we just read, it is freedom, liberty. Yeshua is the Word of God. He is the way. This is what the Bible says in context. When Yeshua dwells in our heart, that means that His Word is in our heart. Remember, the Word of God, the law of God in our heart, is the purpose of the new covenant. And in Hebrew, it's not the new covenant, it's the renewed covenant. God doesn't break covenants. Man breaks covenants. And through Messiah Yeshua, He renewed what man cannot keep. Hebrews chapter 8, verse 10. For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after these days, says the Lord. I will put my laws in their mind and write them on their hearts. And I will be their God, and they shall be my people. So not only did God not cancel His word, His Torah, but He writes it on our heart. And everything in the Old Testament is a shadow of the New. And of course, Hebrews 8:10 is quoted from Jeremiah chapter 31, verse 33. This is the covenant I will make with the people of Israel. After that time, declares the Lord, I will put my law, His word, in their minds and write it on their hearts. I will be their God and they will be my people. If you've called on the name of Jesus, Yeshua, as Lord and Savior of your life, if you're under the blood of Yeshua, then you're grafted into the olive tree and you are spiritually Israel. And God writes His word on your heart. We are to be followers of Jesus, followers of the word. Become Christ-like, Yeshua-like. Yeshua is the word. So we are to follow the word. Being spiritual is following Yeshua's word. He is the word. Ezekiel chapter 36, verse 26 and 27. In Ezekiel 36 is speaking of the context of the new covenant, or in Hebrew, the renewed covenant. I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit within you. I will take the heart of stone out of your flesh and give you a heart of flesh. I will put my spirit within you and cause you to walk in my statutes, and you will keep my judgments and do them. Notice it says when the Holy Spirit dwells inside of us, it'll cause us to walk in His statutes and to keep His judgments and do them. And this is what Romans 8 is speaking about. Romans chapter 8, verse 2. Because through Christ Jesus, Yeshua, the law of the Spirit who gives life has set you free from the law of sin and death. We are no longer under the law of sin and death. Instead, we go after the word, after God's law, being led by the Spirit, the Holy Spirit. This is also the context of Galatians chapter 5, verse 18. But if you are led by the Spirit, you are not under the law. It's the same thing. We are led by the Spirit, and thus we are no longer under the law of sin and death. Let's read Galatians 5:18 again. But if you are led by the Spirit, you are not under the law. This is referring to the law of sin and death. The spiritual, God's word, God's law, produces good fruit. The flesh, which is against God's law, which is the law of sin and death, produces corrupt fruit. Remember, the law, the word, is spiritual. Romans chapter 7, verse 14, we know that the law is spiritual. The spiritual person is to be walking in the Word of God, which is the whole Word of God from Genesis to Revelation, and not going against it. The one who's against the law of God, the Word of God, God's instructions, is walking after the flesh. Romans chapter 8, verse 7, because the mind set on the flesh is hostile toward God, for it does not subject itself to the law. The law here is Torah, which only means God's instruction. Law of God, for it is not able to do so. Let's read Romans 8, 7 again. Because the mind set on the flesh is hostile toward God, for it does not subject itself to the law of God, for it is not even able to do so. Those who do not walk according to the Word of God have a mind that is hostile towards God. That is what the Word of God teaches in context. This is written everywhere in the Bible. This is a biblical pattern. It is the spiritual that love Yeshua and follow His Word. It is those that live in the flesh that hate the law of God, hate the Word of God, and are against it. This may not be a popular message, but it's truth. And the truth can only do one thing, and that is set you free. John chapter 8, verse 32. Then you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. We are not searching for popular messages. We are searching for the truth. This is why it is so important to define biblical terms by using the Bible. There are many people who have a misunderstanding and without even realizing it, are going against the Word of God, trying to cancel the Word of God. But canceling the Word of God, the Torah, God's instruction, is canceling Yeshua, because Yeshua is the Word. Tehillim, Psalms, chapter 40, verse 7. Then I said, here I am, I have come. It is written about me in the scroll. This is not a message that's going to tickle anybody's ears, but it's truth. Salvation came to you and I as a free gift by grace, but it came at a heavy, heavy price. And the blood of Yeshua, Jesus, cannot be taken for granted. Yeshua is the same seed. He's the same light. He's the same way. He's the same life. He's the same truth. He's the same freedom. And He's the same rock. He never changes. His word is forever. He is to be in us and to rule our life. That is how we walk as believers. That is the definition of believing. We cannot take the Word of God that Yeshua Himself preached and change it. Yeshua and the law of God are the same thing. And as I said over and over in this teaching, the word for law in Hebrew is the word Torah. And all Torah means is God's Word. It does not mean following religion or following rabbis who don't believe in Yeshua or following man tradition. It means following only Yeshua, Jesus, in context. Do you love Yeshua? If so, then you love the Word of God, the law of God. Yeshua, Jesus, God, said it with His own mouth. Yohanan, John, chapter 14, verse 15. If you love me, keep my commandments. Do you hate sin? Then you love the Word of God. Do you believe in God, Yeshua? Then you believe in the whole Word, which includes the law of God, because the law is the Word from Genesis to Revelation. Are you led by the Spirit, the Holy Spirit? Then you are led to follow the Word of God. Do you hate the desires of the flesh? Then you love the Word of God. Are you spiritual? Then you are walking in God's Word. So many people are trying to separate the terms already biblically defined for us in the Word. The knowledge is already given to us in the Word. Earlier we read Hosea chapter 4 verse 6, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. What knowledge are we to comprehend? Let's continue and finish that verse. Hosea chapter 4 verse 6, because you have rejected knowledge, I will reject you from being a priest for me. Because you have forgotten the law, the word of your God, I also will forget your children. And we know through Jesus Yeshua, He's our high priest, we are all become priests. But we can see that without following His word, without being in His word, God will reject us from being a priest. We must follow Jesus Yeshua. It doesn't matter what man says, it matters only what Yeshua says. Let's read again what John wrote a few verses after John 3:16. Let's see what believing looks like using the terms the Bible defines for us. John chapter 3 verse 20 to 21. For everyone practicing evil hates the light and does not come to the light, lest his deed should be exposed. But he who does the truth comes to the light, that his deeds may be clearly seen that they have been done in God. Can we redefine these terms outside of Scripture? Is that what John intended under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit? Did John throw away the biblical definitions of light and truth as the Word of God? We understand that the light and the truth is Yeshua, Jesus. Believing in God is loving Yeshua. Yeshua is God, and loving His Word. He is the Word. Believing the Word to be true is the same as hating sin, which is breaking God's Word, God's law, God's instruction. Can one claim that he believes in Yeshua and intentionally not follow His Word? Let's have a look at what Jesus, Yeshua, said to the Pharisees in Matthew 23, because this is what they did. They claimed to believe God, but did not follow the Word. Yeshua commanded in Matthew 23 that we are to observe and do what Moses taught, but not the false traditions and doctrines of the Pharisees. This is why it's very, very important to emphasize that we do not follow the false traditions and doctrines of the Pharisees. That is not Torah. That is man-centered religion. We follow only Jesus, Yeshua. And this is what Jesus taught in Matthew 23. In fact, if we follow the Pharisees in the name of Jesus, then we are grieving the Holy Spirit. And the Bible says, do not grieve the Holy Spirit. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 30. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, with whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Jesus said, if you love me, you keep my commandments. Doing the opposite of what Jesus said means we're grieving the Holy Spirit. Are we not to do everything our Lord Jesus Yeshua commanded and also teach it to the nations? This is what Jesus meant when he said in Matthew chapter 5:14, you are the light of the world. That light, Jesus, lives inside of us, and it defines what we believe to others as a testimony. We cannot separate the Word of God from Yeshua. The Word of God is Yeshua. Loving Yeshua, Jesus, equals loving God's Word. Hating sin equals loving God's Word. 1 John 3:4. Loving God equals doing God's Word. Yeshua died on the cross on the tree for our sins, rose on the third day, and by His blood, we have full redemption of sins and eternal life. Yes, we are saved by grace, but we need to die in Messiah Yeshua daily, sanctify daily, repent daily, and follow His Word, and make it to the end as the bride of Jesus, Yeshua. Walking as Yeshua walked means walking the same instructions that Yeshua walked. 1 John chapter 2, verse 6. Whoever claims to live in Him must live as Jesus Yeshua did. We cannot pretend that some of the Word is no longer the Word of God, or that it's been changed, or that it's been canceled. Once again, I'll say it, if we cancel anything in the Word of God, then we've canceled Jesus Yeshua, because Yeshua is the Word. The Bible is not a restaurant. You can't just pick and choose whatever you want. God is not asking you what you like. God is saying, abide in me, and I will abide in you. That is the whole Word of God. John 15, verse 4. Abide in me, and I in you. If Yeshua is the Word, then how can we say that some of God is true and some is not? He's either the Word or He's not. If we believe that He is the Word, then we must follow the whole Word of God from Genesis to Revelation in context. Our faith saves us because we can never do anything to save ourselves. That's grace. Grace means unmerited favor. At the same time, our faith is in the Word, and the Word made flesh. Faith means that we believe that the Word is true. In our faith, can we continue to do things contrary to the truth? What faith would that be? Our faith is our inward belief, but any inward belief becomes our outward practice. Let's experience all the Word of God, all the grace, all the truth, all the light that Yeshua has for us. Psalms 119, verse 105. Your word is a lamp for my feet and a light on my path. Yeshua is the Alpha and the Omega in Hebrew, the Aleph and the Taf. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And His word is forever. Because He is the Word. And that is what it means, the Aleph and the Taf, the Alpha and the Omega. In the book of Revelation, there is a call for the saints of God to run the race and make it to the end. Revelation chapter 14, verse 12. This calls for patience and endurance on the part of the people of God who keep His commandments and remain faithful to Jesus, Yeshua. Notice it says, who keep the word of God and remain faithful to Jesus, Yeshua. It doesn't say to cancel the word of God. It says to keep the word of God. I pray this teaching has blessed you as it has blessed me over the years. Let's continue to stand together as the one new man, Ephesians 2:15. Bring the gospel back to Jerusalem and go home. Until next time, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, sending you blessings from Jerusalem, Israel, in the mighty name of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, Aliyeh Yehuda, Jesus Yeshua. Amen.